example, Namaste, good morning to all respected online viewers. Long live their majesties, long live our leaders, and long live our friendship. Welcome to this online yoga workshop, Embassy of India, Thimphu, ICCIR's Nehru Wangchuk Culture Center. Yoga teacher and KVSSN Murthy here. My sincere praise to the Almighty to see all the best things to their majesties in the whole Bhutan. And coming to sun salutations. So today also we have sun salutations with mantra chanting, and after that we have a very good row of exercises, stick yoga. So like anyone can adopt this kind of methods and exercises in your regular yoga exercises. So keep your position straight, then lift your both the arms with inhalation and above to the head, called pranama mudra or kailasha mudra. Then very slowly bring your pranama mudra towards your chest region, called anahata pranamasana. And here we have chantings, and according to your belief system you can follow, or you can follow only physical exercises. Om hiranmayena patrena satyasyapi hitam mukham tatvam pushan apavrunu satya dharmaya drushtaye. Om ram bhim hrum haim hraum raha मित्र रवि सूर्य भानु गगपूष्ण हिरण्य गर्भमरीच आदित्य सवित्र अर्क भास्कराय नमः. Stretch your arms forward, lift your arms up, hasta uttanasan, according to your flexibility. Once pull up, after that bend the body back, ardha chandrasan or ardha chakrasan. Then again keep your body straight, again once pull up. If you have any issue related to lower back or spine or the blood pressure or heart or facial organ disorders because of forward bend, so avoid forward bend. So completely bend the body forward, remaining participants completely bend the body forward up to the maximum limit or at your convenient pace, called Pada Hasta Asana. Then after that right leg stretch back, called Aswa Sanchalanasana or horse riding posture. Push your body down as well as forward, lift your chin up. Throughout the practice, keep giving that sensitive pressure at the abdomen because of your knee interaction and thigh interaction. Then, and back leg straight on the toes. Then slowly join your forward leg to back leg, called Dandasana or Santulanasana. And after that, very slowly push your body down towards the floor, called Ashtanga Namaskarasana or Sastanga Namaskarasana. And after relaxation, then very slowly push your body forward and lift the body up like a sea wave, called Bhujangasana or lifted head cobra posture. And from there another way of semi-inverted posture and forward bend, called Parvatasana. Take care while doing this kind of exercises. And right leg again forward, leg called Aswa Sanchalanasana or horse riding posture. And back leg straight on the toes, and back leg knee up, join your back leg to forward leg, called Pada Hastasana. And very slowly lift your arms and the body up, called Hasta Uttanasana or lifted arms posture. Then slightly or medium or deep back bend, Ardha Chandrasana or Ardha Chakrasana. Then again keep your body straight, pranamasana above to the head, Kailasha Mudra. Then very slowly bring your pranamasana down at your chest level, Anahata Pranamasana. And feel a small break, take a long deep inhalation, exhalation. After that, along with your inhalation, lift your arms, and exhalation, wide your hands. Then very slowly keep them down towards your thighs. Then soon after that, lock your hands back and keep due distance between your legs, keep your toes straight, and few seconds break. And then stride. So now try to catch any convenient stick or pipe, but please remember, when you want to do this kind of exercises in your home, take care of your electric and electronic appliances. So hold your stick and long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. So after warm-ups, or you can take sun salutation as warm-ups before adding this kind of stick exercises into your practices. So take a long deep inhalation, exhalation, keep your sticks straight. So now we are doing Samakona Asana or somewhat body angular posture or right angle posture. So keep your both the legs bit distance. Then after that keep give proper distance between the stick and the body, and hold your stick, hold your vertical stick with your two hands at one position. So with interlock or without interlock, but your hands should not get away from the same grip. So try to push your body forward. Then throughout the practice, try to keep move your head down.
So increase your bending and hanging and for a while stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then very slowly come straight to normal. Take again long deep inhalation, exhalation. So same exercise in the cross angle. Then same exercise we are doing in between your both the legs. Create that equal space or medium space or maximum space according to your convenience. And push your stick forward. Here also keep giving proper distance between your body and the stick. Alright, so here in front of the chest level, hold your two arms. Then push your body completely forward. Then after that, keep hang the body. Here you can slightly drag your arms down according to your convenient rate. But see, your body must be parallel to the floor and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then very slowly keep push your body back. Then once relax your body, then after that take a long, deep and slow inhalation and exhalation. So few seconds, long, slow inhalations and exhalations. So the first posture what we just finished now, the Samakonasana, right angle posture. In fact, that is not a forward bending, but while looking, it looks like a forward bend, but anyhow, we are doing one back bending posture also. Very simple exercise. Again, keep your stick vertical and keep your sticks close to the body and keep your body straight. Then this time, lift your two arms up above to the head and at one point lock your two hands. Just try to lift your chin up and push your body for a back bend. Here try to hang the body with the arm support. So itself it is called as a Ardha Chakrasana, Uttita Hasta Ardha Chakrasana, or a simple half wheel posture variation. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 relaxations, enough, come back. Then very slowly keep your arms down, take a long, slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. So once check your breath and check your leg distance and check your dress and check your stick positions. So take a long, deep inhalation, exhalation. So our next exercise based on the same angular posture is called Dvikona Asana or double angle posture. So this is also a kind of body pushing, but keep your legs in a equal distance, shoulder distance or more than that, but be very convenient while keeping your legs in proper distancing. So right, now hold your sticks with your two arms. All right, try to lift your sticks up, then try to bend the body forward, and here also arrange your arms at the equal distance, or still you can create the same contracted arms position also, but be very convenient this posture called Dvikona Asana or double angle posture. So slightly lift your chin up and observe the strain on the neck. If you felt like strain, keep your head straight or keep your nose point towards the floor and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then very slowly come straight to normal. Then slowly keep your sticks down. Take a long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. And these exercises will give you some kind of leg stretching, especially hamstring muscle stretch and also leg stretching, and also good for the people who are having arm strains and arm pains and shoulder pains. But please remember, when you have lower back issues or above back issues, take care while doing, or take support chair or table and do, or still you can avoid the practices. Okay, long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalations. And depend on the same Dvikonasana, we have Uttita Lola Asana or swinging while standing, Uttita Lola Asana. So here keep your legs with distance. So a small gap or medium gap or maximum gap in between your legs. Alright, this time hold your sticks with your two arms. So this is also comes under a slight forward bend. So take care while doing. If you have any issues, avoid the practices. So right, lift your both the arms up. So long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. Alright, and now very slowly push your body forward till your ankles or till your foot. Just lift your arms up again, keep your body straight. Then again completely bend and touch your ankle or floor or legs and come back. Then second count, touch and come back. So this is a simple swinging exercise. So it will give you good flexibility at your neck level to lower back level, and also good stretches. It will give good stretches at your legs level and thigh level. And then take a long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. Then soon after that, put your stick behind your body and both the legs together. So with your elbow support, just few seconds feel that back bending. Lift your chin and few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then very slowly come back. Take again long inhalation to give extra stretches as a back bend. Hold your sticks with your two arms, contract your both the arms, and further giving the bend called Ardha Chakrasana. So push your body forward and turn your shoulders back, turn your elbows back, point your elbows towards the backside and lift your head up and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and relaxations. In a very slowly come straight to normal, and long and slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. So once relax your arms, relax your neck, relax your legs, and keep your legs just to fold and open as a segment of four stitches. And long and slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. So like till now we performed Samakonasana, Dvikonasana, as well as Uttita Lola Asana and swinging while standing postures. These are all basically related to somewhat forward bends. Also good for the for the people who are having shoulder issues, and also for the people who wants to get good flexibility. For them, these are very simple exercises, and also these are all good postures in managing the obesity and in managing the constipations also. So take a long deep inhalation and exhalation. So here our next exercise will be Dolasana or pendulum posture. So here wide your legs to the maximum or medium. According to your flexibility, you can wide your legs also. So here very simple posture. Turn your right leg to the right side. Turn your right leg to the right side. Hold your stick with your two arms and place your sticks on the neck, turn your body towards your open leg, towards your right leg. So here you can open your hands or you can close your hands, but if you already closed your hands and put a good grip on the stick or open the arms, just towards your right side completely bend, push your body down towards the leg and then very slowly come back. And we are doing first exercise mode, after that we are doing a posture. Then again completely press your body down towards the knee and very slowly come back. So last count, push your body towards the knee and stay. Now here you can change your arms for good grip. Like instead of pushing the body, do not do overstrain on the neck. And completely press your head towards the leg and stay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 relaxations. Enough. Very slowly come back. Then turn your body straight and keep your legs straight and slowly legs together, and once put your sticks straight. And soon after this practices, first exercise, first postures at your shoulder level. Lift your shoulders and slowly come straight. Second count, lift your shoulders and slowly come straight. Last count, lift your shoulders and then slowly come back. Then after that, lift your head to the right side and to the left side. Just go for your chin up half cycles to give extra relaxation to the neck level. Then comes rest. Take a long, deep inhalation, exhalation. So here, during the kind of practices along with the stick exercises, use this stick as a simple prop only. Like, do not overstrain your body. Don't overstrain that concerned neck muscles or hands or legs. Okay, take a long, slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. So our next posture, the same Dolasana or pendulum posture, opposite side. So here also, wide your legs to the medium or maximum distance and turn your left leg to the left side. Turn your left leg to the left side and now put your sticks on the neck. Turn your body towards your left side and open your arms or contract your hands. Open your hands or contract your hands. So make your good grip if you already contracted your hands. Alright, do not overstrain on the neck. Don't do over pressing on the neck. But instead of that, then slowly push your body for exercising till your leg or till your convenient point bend and slowly come back to normal. Again, second count, bend and then come back to normal. Lost count, bend and stay now, and try to give extra pressure on the neck if possible, if you can, and if you want to put your head towards the leg and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then very slowly come straight to normal. Then very slowly turn your head straight and turn your leg straight and keep your body straight now. And here also keep your sticks vertical. Then few seconds rest your shoulders. 1 and come straight. Second counts 2 and come straight. So last counts 3, lift your shoulder and relax your shoulder. Then soon after that, then same way of head half cycles. Relax your neck, relax your head, and relaxations enough. Take again long and slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. And next posture will be very simple and effective posture, Hasta Uttanasana. Hasta Uttanasana is a posture of only arm stretching posture. So for the people who don't have much time to do all the yoga exercises, for them you can do this simple exercise also every day with stick or without stick. So keep your position straight. And if you have stick, hold your stick with your two arms. Then try to keep pull yourself up, still up, and slightly or deep or medium, slight back bend and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and relaxations enough. Very slowly keep your arms down, and long and slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. So once relax your arms and relax your fist, relax your shoulders, and relax your neck if you want. Alright, take a long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalation. So during your yoga exercises, initially, every posture can be performed with only 10 seconds only. So no need to do extra time. But once when you totally into the yoga practices, you can slowly, gradually increase that time. For the same Hasta Uttanasana, we have vertical stick position. So keep your stick vertically on the back of the body, but keep your stick properly land back of the body. And hold your stick with your two arms. Then at the single point or at the two points, hold a proper grip. Right here, take care while balancing. So try to push your body forward and completely bend the body back and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And relaxations enough. Very slowly come back to normal. Take again long and slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. And during this same exercises or for the same exercises, if you can really coordinate with the two sticks help, now that will add somewhat good benefit to your exercises. But please remember, while organizing one stick, we need lots of patience and lots of awareness. And if we want to use two sticks, our awareness should be double. So now here, hold your sticks with your two arms and put it back of the body, and hold your two sticks with your two hands. Then slightly or medium distance in between your legs to keep your balance safe. Then try to push your body forward and try to maintain your back bend and stay now. So somewhat it will relieve the body strength, and also it will take your body weight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then very slowly come straight to normal. Then soon after that, keep your sticks straight and take a long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. So the whole practices, yoga, the purpose of whole practices is to make us alert, also to create interest while performing the postures. Okay, take a long, slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. Then after that, our next exercise is called Ardha Chandrasana, crescent posture. So this also can be performed with the single stick use and as well as double stick use. So I'll show how easy it is while using this kind of simple props. So right, and now keep your body straight. So now we are doing Ardha Chandrasana. So keep your right leg back. Ardha Chandrasana we are doing, keep your right leg back. So we have many variations in the name of Ardha Chandrasana. Today I will show two variations. So So keep your right leg back and put your sticks close to the abdomen from the right side, in front of the body from the right side. And hold your stick with your right hand and left hand. So still drag your leg back. Alright, few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4. During the same stay, keep open your back leg side hand to go for more bending. And 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then very slowly come back to normal. Then slowly drag your leg forward with the help of the stick. And few seconds rest your leg and long pause. And similar exercise, opposite side, keep your body straight. Once check your convenience and check your breath. Then after that, very slowly open your left leg as a back leg. And push your body forward. And from the in front of the body, from the left side gap, put your sticks closer to the abdomen. So initially hold your stick with your two arms to keep your body balance safe. Once you will be alright in the balance, and leave your back leg side's hand, means left hand up, to bend the body more. And stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then very slowly come back to normal and attach your hand to the stick and very slowly push your body and relaxations enough. Take again long and slow and deep inhalation, exhalation. And for this same Ardha Chandrasana variation, we can add our stick back of the body also. So it will give you more easiness for the same posture. So right, keep your body straight. Take a long, deep inhalation, exhalation. So this time, open your left leg as a back leg. Open your left leg as a back leg. Then put your sticks behind the body in the line of the right leg, but behind the body at the right side only. And right, push your body forward, hold your stick with your two arms and go for a more bending on the like on the stick support. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then relaxing, just keep your leg fold. Then after that, very slowly and with an easy way, keep your body relaxed. Then after that, take a long, slow and a deep inhalation and exhalation. So we can do our yoga exercises with more simple and with more easiness while adding this kind of simple probes into our practices. And right, opposite side, we are doing same exercise, we are doing opposite side. So right this time, keep your right leg as a back leg. Keep your right leg as a back leg. Check your forward leg condition and check your breath and check your dress and check your mat. Then try to put your sticks back of the body on the left side, in the line of the left leg, in the line of the left leg but back of the body. Alright, and now hold your stick with your two arms or one hand. So completely push your body forward while hanging or while holding the stick properly. And here 10 seconds enough. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then slowly come back to normal. Keep your back leg down on the floor. Then slowly put your sticks forward and relax with the back leg supported and up. Take again long and slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. And to create another variation for this same Ardha Chandrasana, we had another variation in same Ardha Chandrasana. Keep your sticks on your right side and take a long pause. Then after that, widen your legs. Then turn your right leg to the right side. Turn your right leg to the right side. So put your sticks on the right side. Take care while doing this kind of advanced balancing. You can put your chair also under your right hand, or you can put bricks also under your right hand. But as anyhow, today we are doing our stick exercise. We can add stick also for the arm support. Alright, now lift your alternate arm up. Then keep drag your right arm down. Catch your stick with the two hands, then very slowly adjust your stick. Then after that, push your body more forward, more convenient. Be very convenient by lifting the alternate leg up and few seconds stay in this posture now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then here, according to your convenience and balance, you can move your below hand down towards the floor also. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then very slowly come back to normal by keeping your arm and leg straight. Alright, take again long and slow inhalation, exhalation, few seconds, due relaxation by taking long way of inhalations and exhalations. So while in the practices during the postures or while in the relaxation, if you felt like giddiness or over tiredness or any dizziness, so few seconds time sit on the floor or on the chair, and few seconds relaxation after that, resume the class. Then here opposite side, same thing, Ardha Chandrasana opposite side variation, keep your six on the left side. So it may be, it may want more distance also according to your height and according to your sticks length, distance may getting some variations, is depend on the people to people how they are practicing. But take care while doing, and turn your left leg to the left side and put your sticks slightly far from the left leg. Then after that, use your right arm, lift your right arm to catch your stick with the right arm above to the head. At the same time, drag your left arm down and slowly push your body forward, adjust your legs to keep your the same posture, safe side. Alright, and now lift your right leg and few seconds put this horizontal way of the body and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, here you can leave your below hand down towards the floor to touch the floor to create more balance. And 7, 8, 9, 10, and very slowly come back to normal and relaxations. Enough. Again, long and slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. Few seconds. prepare yourself to getting more relaxation. Alright, today's our last posture will be Ardha Chakrasana or half wheel posture. So here also we have 3 or 4 variations. So while using the stick, every variation will be easy. So right, take a long pause. So here, keep your body straight. So as we mentioned that, lift your arms up to hold your stick. So first variation will be as it is, the arms down in between your legs. If you need a kind of distance for balancing, slightly give a distance between your both the legs. Hold your sticks with your two arms. Alright, push your body forward to give a back bend and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and relaxation enough, come back. Then same thing here, keep your sticks on the neck level. And here also contract your hands. Keep push your body forward to bend back and lift your chin and stay. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Relaxations enough, come back. Then very slowly drag your sticks from your neck level to above back level and contract your both the arms. So again, adjust your legs for more bending if you can and if you want. So please remember, you can do any one variation and after that you can relax, or you can choose all the variations also. Alright, and now keep pushing the body forward and it is same bending. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Relaxations enough. After that, very slowly drag your sticks further down towards the lower back or mid back and contract your hands more. Then here also once push your body and for more bending, and here also count starts only 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then relaxations enough. Take a long and slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. Alright, to create that extra bending on the same stick, you can hold one stick or you can put two sticks also. As we mentioned that with the two sticks, practice will be so easy, as well as we need to concentrate on the balance and on the sticks positions also. Alright, let's do our extra bending with the stick interference. Hold your stick with your both the arms. In between your both the legs, create a space. And preparation is take a long, deep inhalation and exhalation. Alright, according to your convenience, bend the body back and stay here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Then very slowly come back to normal. And take a long, slow, and deep inhalation and exhalation. And using this kind of props, even though we are using the simple props, but take care while organizing the props. Okay, take a long, slow, and deep inhalation and exhalation. And soon after this, keep your sticks away. And further increase your time limit for relaxation to keep your arms locked back in between your both legs. Create a small space. And with only long inhalations and exhalations also, we can get good relaxations. Then straight. Keep your body straight and take a long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. And still more long inhalations and exhalations. And coming to pranayama, prana sadhana or pranayama sadhana. So choose any convenient surface on the chair or on the mat or any other good surface. And please remember, it is also advised that after soon after finishing your physical yoga practices, physical yogic way of exercises, it is advised to give a small time gap to create some relaxation to the body in shavasana. If you have more time, you can do the shavasana, or you can choose one or two pillows also to keeping under the lower back or above back to give more relaxation to the body in the same shavasana. And also advised to drink a sip of a small amount of water, especially for the people who are having this attitude towards the mantra chantings. Okay, and now coming to prana sadhana or pranayama practice, choose any convenient and comfortable posture, lotus or half lotus, or you can choose any other convenient posture also. And take a long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. So here we have sloka and the chantings.
Om Kesavaya Swaha, Om Madhavaya Swaha, Om Narayanaya Swaha, Om Adya Samadhi Tatpala Siddhyardham Asana Purvakan Pranayamadin Karishye. Om Sandhi Sandhi Sandhi.
Then slowly keep your hands down and take a long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. So in other words, this chanting saying that the practices in yoga or the pranayam or all styles of the yoga or many advanced practices in yoga, purpose is the same, called one is to keeps us healthy in physical level as well as mental level and social level. Also it should use as the disciplined way of life, and also it should fit to make us to be ready to take spiritual upliftment goals also. So through yoga, these are very simple and effective. Only thing is, if we have continuity with devotion, everything will be possible. So take a long, deep inhalation and exhalation. So here also we have the two exercises. Kapala Bhati is a Kriya Abhyas. And second one is Bhramari Pranayam. It is a kind of sound making breathing exercise. So it is saying that in Kapala Bhati, it is saying that Vastrava loha karasya recha purav sasam bhramau kapala bhatir vikyata kapadosha visoshani. It is saying that a systematic stroke and speed in the especially breathe outs will create a kind of repeated friction and vacuum on the mucus level, so that the total extra mucus or the mucus dosha, the errors in the dosha will be comes under totally control. And also it is based on the practice style and practice level and practice strength, this Kriya will give you benefits in the management of obesity as well as constipation and management of ab level organ health. But only thing is,
how intensity we have in the practices are is important. And coming to Bhramari Pranayam, it is a sound making pranayam or B breath. It is saying that Vaghat Gosha Purakam Brunga Nadam Brungi Nadam Brunga Nadam Brungi Nadam Rechanam Manda Mandam Yogindra Nameva Abhyasa Yoga Chitte Jataka Chidananda Leela. So here Brunga Nadam and Brungi Nadam, male and female, it's a composition of male and female sounds. It should create like making a reverberating sound like the male and female black bee, especially in exhaling and inhaling. These vibrations will improve the circulation of the circulation as well as the glands health also, blood circulation as well as the glands health also. And also it, this vibration or this kind of the kind of practices based on the strength level of the practitioner, these exercises will be kind of good practices to drag the mind into the meditations and concentration and also mantra chanting, especially for the people who wants to do advanced level of meditations as well as advanced level of mantra sadhan. For them, these are very simple and effective practices, Bhramari practices. So all about this Bhramari practice, all about the create the resonance. This is the resonance not really belongs to the physical activity, it's also activity for the mind and also activity for the spiritual attitudes. Right, coming to the practices, practices are very simple, but only thing is if you already had ear issues or any other mental disturbances and or any other related issues in the head, please do not perform Bhramari Pranayam, or you can follow very slow vibrations and slow intensity. So remaining people can do. So take a long deep inhalation, exhalation. First, we will finish our Kapalabhati practice. And here also you can keep your position straight. To keep your position straight, you can hold your knees with your both the arms, especially for the above back strengthening. So here coming to Kapalabhati, that this is a forced exhalation, slow inhalation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and inhalation and exhalation. And coming to second spell, the same thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, take a long deep inhalation and exhalation. And coming to third, last spell. Then starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, long and slow and a deep inhalation and exhalation. A small gap after your Kriya Abhyasa or cranium cleansing technique. This is also called as Balabhati. As we mentioned that it can control the total phlegm level issues. And Bhati means it is a kind of quality of perception or quality of knowledge or quality of glowing. This glowing also, this name Bhati is related to the spiritual meaning only. Okay, take a long deep inhalation, exhalation. Coming to Bhramari practice, the sound making practice. But we have here, we have two exercises. One is making sound while inhalation and making sound while exhalation. But here in this practice, we are making sound while in the breathe out only, called Bhramari. It's a female B sound. Right, keep your body straight. And now, like close your ears with your fingers or with the palms. And completely deep breathe in. While breathe out and make the sound called that female B sound. Again, completely deep breathe in. Again, completely deep breathing. Then soon after that, very slowly open the hands, then slowly turn your hands and put them on the knees. So after these practices, so this week, as we know that we are doing Bhairava Mudra. The Bhairava Mudra, contextual wise, in English we can understand the intensity or the extreme, the extreme activity of the mind towards these spiritual practices. So here, put your right arm on the top and the left arm below, and keep your the same two palms joining at the navel level. So take a long deep inhalation, exhalation. And here in this mudra or in this special practice, our two hands represent Ida and Pingala nadis, or male and female energies inside the body, which will respond to union our mind into the spiritual consciousness. And also this mudra is used in prana mudra, and also be one of the best exercises, best practices while in the meditations and pranayam practices, and also in the mantra chantings. So here, take a long deep inhalations and exhalations. Then after that, relax from the practices and give some more time to take power nap or do yoga nidra to create more space for relaxation for the body and mind. And once you will able to finish your total yoga workout, and based on the strength level and based on the style and based on your intensity level in the practices, it may advise to take 15 minutes time to half an hour time to take bath, and further 10 to 15 minutes time to take breakfast. This times totally depend on the people to people. And in the afternoon, once you will be free from your activities before your lunch time, and try to see all the possibilities how to take a power nap or how to do a yoga nidra to rejuvenate yourself, to create more clarity in the thought, and to create more clarity in decision making. And in the evenings, once you will be totally free from your all activities and affairs before your dinner time, and you try to see all the possibilities to take a half an hour self yoga practices, including back bending exercises and inverted postures and leg stretchings, and along with these pranayam practices also. And please remember, evening body is so flexible than the morning body, and try to take that benefit from the body, especially in the evenings. And tomorrow, when we are meeting here at the same place with the same content, we will see still more good exercises in yoga. Tomorrow we have office yoga or furniture yoga, or we have chair yoga. And thanking you all to giving me this wonderful opportunity. And stay away from the bad habits and do yoga also. Thanking you all.